PV wrote an article about this where he enumerates a number of problems with the way that slow play is evaluated by judges and his solution for them.
Okay.
So one of the problems that he illustrates is that it's very inconsistent, that it's basically a totally subjective thing, which it doesn't need to be, right? I mean, time isn't subjective,
right?
You can get out a stopwatch, you can say, like, this guy took 60 seconds for his turn. Now, how complicated a person's decision is, that is subjective, but I feel like they're not supposed to take that into account or something like that. They're not supposed to take the board state into account. I can't remember exactly.
Right.
But basically, you can standardize it.
Yeah.
And he shows examples where it's like, someone takes 30 seconds. I mean, all of PV's examples are of him getting called for slow play and his opponent not.
Of course, that's just PV, so.
Yeah.
But
I told him, I was like, can you find some examples where you got called for slow play? And he's like, nah, I just can't find any. Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
But yeah, somewhere like 30 seconds will go by, he gets called for slow play, and then he passes the turn, or he attacks and his opponent's thinking about blocking, and they take 60 seconds,
yeah.
And the judge doesn't say anything. So that's the first problem. Have you encountered that when you play a tournament yourself?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I generally play fairly quickly until, you know, there are those couple of very, very important decisions where the wrong decision is just going to end up losing you the game. And I don't know how you're supposed to evaluate that as a judge. It's kind of difficult.
Right.
Like, you know, let's say I'm playing Storm and I'm about to go off and I'm just making sure I'm running the numbers and everything's correct. But it's much harder to come up with, you know, math everything out in that one instance than like somebody playing like a Miracles deck and topping in response to like a spell.
Right.
So it's, once again, I mean, I feel like it's best to just leave it up to the judges, but I don't know what the proper standard would be, because there are certain turns that are far more difficult than when somebody's standing there turn one and figuring out what land to play and takes like 2 minutes.
Right.
That's just unacceptable.
Yeah, so, and one of the other things that he talks about is how it seems like, basically, if you were to take one big lesson away from his article, it's that judges should sort of watch for a while, carefully, to see if a player is playing slowly over a series of turns.
Right.
Because one of the problems that he points out is that the first one is that like taking an action will kind of like reset your clock. You know, if you like imagine like punching a chess clock.
So tank, play a land, tank,
yeah.
Fetch, tank.
And then if you do what he does, which is think through your whole turn, and then take all of your actions at once very quickly, you'll see someone like Patrick Chapin do this too. They'll sit there for a while, and it looks like they're just not doing anything, and then they'll boom, 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 go.
Yeah.
And that you can take 50 seconds to do that, and if you're thinking for 50 seconds and then move very quickly, you're way more likely to get called for slow play than if you pass to someone who takes 20 seconds, takes an action, 20 seconds, takes an action, 20 seconds, takes an action.
Right.
That one is way more likely to be called than the other. And so a solution for that is just wait until the end of the turn and see if it took the same amount of time.
Yeah. Yeah, that's totally reasonable. I mean, you asked me before if I've gotten warnings for slow play, and I have. And it feels like a lot of the times that I do get the warnings, I feel like the judges just want something to happen. Like,
right.
Like he's just like, oh, I want to give out X warnings today.
Yeah.
So it's like, all right, you got to slow. I'm like, are you kidding me? It's like, you know, turn two. And I just
your
like,
unlucky day, my friend.
Yeah, yeah. And it, you know, I feel like there needs to be a level of consistency. I actually know that Josh Silvestri, he works with Channel Fireball. He actually wrote like a pretty detailed article with and he shared it amongst the judges as to like what should consist of slow play.
Yeah.
But I don't know if it's been adopted by all of the judges. But I mean, yeah, I've had some judges kind of gung ho, like, all right, slow play warning. I was like, what? Like,
yeah.
What's going on? And I'm sure PV thinks the same way, you know. And I mean, I don't know. I know what the judges do and like how they talk about things completely different than like my perspective as a player. So like, I don't know what exactly they're looking for, but yeah, like, I don't know how they can actually change that. Because like I said, if it's a complicated turn, should you be allowed more time? Or should everybody just be given the same amount of time?
It seems reasonable that if you've got way more to think through, then it makes sense. I mean, it sort of seems like what you want is access to a chess clock. And this is sort of where we should mention that people have tried to use a chess clock in Magic. It hasn't really worked out. It seems like the easiest solution, because that's what we have on Magic Online, right? It's basically a chess clock.
Right.
It doesn't really work, because there's all these priority passes. I mean, you'd have to slam that thing pretty fast if you're like, okay, okay, and then how do you F6, you know?
Yeah, yeah, it works out a lot better.
Kepler did at that one Pro Tour that Eggs won, where he just wrote F6 on a piece of paper and then stuck it on the table.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
I didn't see that.
One thing that I've experienced, and I'm curious if you feel this way as well, is, first of all, I think it's hard to call your opponent for slow play in general. Now, once you get more experience and once you're a little more seasoned, I think maybe it's easier for you to, like, encourage your opponent to play a little faster in a nice, assertive way. But when there's a judge sitting there and they're watching, but they're clearly not paying attention for slow play. I mean, sometimes they're just doing something else, right? Keeping life totals in the feature match area, or they're watching for some kind of different problem or whatever, might be distracted because, you know, they're anticipating another call somewhere else. When there's a judge there, do you feel like you can't ask your opponent to play faster because it's like you're telling that judge that he's not doing his job?
No, I think, but that's because
Would you tell a player to play faster while a judge is sitting there watching?
Definitely.
And have you?
Yes, but I think that comes from, I guess, playing more.
Yeah.
You know, when I first started playing Magic, it was mostly online, and so I'd never really had that. You know, you play and make sure you don't time out your clock. And when I first made the leap onto playing, you know, cardboard Magic, that was something I wasn't familiar with, and you know, it felt really kind of awkward for me to ask him to play faster because that's just not my nature to just be like, "Hey, do this." You know, we're just playing a game; we want to have fun, but. As you play more and more, you're like, well, time is a thing, and getting a draw because your opponent plays slow is not something you want to do, especially when you're playing Grand Prix and you know there's a lot of you know pro points and money on the line. So I just let my opponent know. It's like, hey, you know, you need to make a decision.
Yeah.
Right. And if he continues to tank, you know, I try to be reasonable. I'm like, all right, well, I'm gonna call the judge and ask him, hey, could you watch this? You know, we're trying to finish this match. We need to just play at a reasonable pace. So I try to do it without like. Kind of trying to come off as like a real big jerk or anything, but I do, if my opponent is taking an unreasonable amount of time on their turns, then like I do try to get them to play faster. Even and if a judge is there, it's actually easier for me because I can just be like, hey judge, can you just watch this match?
Yeah.
The best
solution that I heard to that came from Sam Pardee, which is that he said that judges enforcing slow play has become a sort of unrecorded caution that they'll say, I need you to make a play. And then the player speeds up.
Yeah.
And while the judge is watching, they're playing faster. And then the judge walks away. And, you know, not because of anything malicious by the player, but they get to another hard turn and the judge is gone and
there's no pressure.
Just a little slower or whatever. Yeah. And they start to slow down again. And that's not recorded anywhere. And then they go to the next round and the same thing happens. And, you know, another judge might walk by and say, I need you to play a little faster. No one is recording this. So that can happen all the way through an entire event where someone is playing below what is a reasonable pace of play.
Yeah.
So it seems like systematizing how you hand out warnings for slow play, and you need to have better standards for what slow play is in order to do that. Seems like a good solution to me.
Should there also be like a way of putting it on their record, like on their DCI, like this person has a history of slow play?
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, you know, there are certain players who play competitively.
If you get like a DQ'd from an event, then that goes on your record. But
yeah, if you get like a game loss, for example, for slow play,
right,
then, you know, That's something that the judges can look out for in the future, you know, because there are even players on the tour who are notorious for kind of being more methodical or what have you.
Yeah, yeah. So, I mean, you know, I said, it's nothing malicious. It's just you both have 50 minutes to finish a match, and at some point you're taking time away.
Magic is a hard game. Sometimes you got to think through them, through your turns. Yeah,
I can't ever figure it out. My problem is always that I'm playing too fast. I need to like
slow down. Yeah.
Like, oh, you just played a misbind click, and there's no fairy to champion.
Yeah. But you're like, Miss Pine Click, it's so good. I got to play turn four.
Yeah.